In the previous videos, we saw about remix, recut, blend and loop feature of Sora. And today in this video, we are going to see about storyboard feature, arguably one of the most amazing features offered by OpenAI Sora. So let's get started. So first, let me begin by why do we need this storyboard feature and what are the advantages that it gives. So firstly, to create a video in Sora, we will just give a prompt, a text, and Sora will give the video corresponding to that prompt. And in this case, we won't be having much control about the scenes or the visuals or the movements that are appearing in this video. And by using this storyboard feature, we will be able to describe each and every scene in that video and have smooth transitions and bind them together. So basically, this storyboard feature helps us to have more control and give more in-depth visuals as well as descriptions for our video. That's the main purpose of it. So to access the storyboard feature, just comes to all videos and you'll be having the storyboard button over here. Just click here and this is the interface that we will be getting. So first, this is exactly quite similar to the editing timeline that we see in our editing softwares like Premiere Pro or CapCut. So if we change this duration, that is the output video duration, this timeline will also change. Currently it is at 10 seconds because I have selected here 10 seconds. So if I click here 5 seconds, I'll be getting here 5 seconds. So for this demo, I will go with 16:9, exactly the same settings. And I will just go with 480p because that's when I get 10 seconds. I'm using the plus subscription. Alright. So I'll generate two videos. So basically what we will be doing is we will have many scenes to a video. So imagine we want to create a video of a dog going and eating its food. So in the first scene, we will be having the food in a particular bowl. And in the next scene, we will be having the dog walking. And the final scene, we will be having the dog eating. So this particular scene has three phases or three parts. And if we do all these things in a single prompt, we won't be getting the perfect of outputs. But using the storyboard feature, we can tailor perfect those. So let's see a sample one. So currently you will be getting this like a scene. By default, you will be having one scene like this. And as I told you, I want two more scenes. So you are just going to click here anywhere. The first scene will come from 0 second to 3 seconds. In that case, if you want the first scene to be 3 seconds, come here and click here. So this will be the second scene. So as I told you, the first scene is going to be, we'll be having a food in the bowl, a dog's bowl. And the second scene, we'll be having dog walking. And as I told you, the final scene is going to be the dog eating its food. So I want that scene to come another 3 seconds after this. So I'll go with 7. So here I'll be having my description. And this description need not be necessary prompt or something. You can even upload your own image or video or choose from your library. I prefer giving it in a prompt. So I'll just go with a prompt. So I'll just come here. This is going to be my prompt. So I have just typed this prompt. It's basically owner keeps the dog's food on the bowl. And if you want this to get more in detail, you are having this expand caption. So by using AI, Sora just gets us a highly detailed and specific prompt like this. This is amazing. And the next one here, this is going to be our second scene. As I told you, the dog is walking towards the food. So this is what I'm giving. The door opens and the dog is walking towards the food. And I will just go with expand caption. And at the end, the final scene. So this is the one that I give. The dog happily eats its food. And I will just go with expand caption. So this particular prompt will occupy the first 3 seconds. And this particular prompt will occupy the next 3 seconds. If you want to move this, you can move this. How many seconds each and every prompt has to fill the gap or fill the timeline. So if you want, you can minimize it. I would recommend you to have like 2-3 seconds gap so that Sora has the time to like connect and have a smooth transition between each and every scene. Alright. So I guess this is pretty much fine. And you can just play around with these settings, the presets, the number of videos that you want to generate, the duration and stuff. And once you're done, once you're good with this, you can just click on create. That's it, added to the queue. Okay, I have got the outputs over here. So in my first video, the owner is keeping the food, which is our first prompt, and the dog is coming and eating the food, the dog walks and eat the food. So this is kind of okay, this has done our prompt. And in case if you want to edit again, edit the storyboard again, so here the prompts are displayed, and if you want to edit it again, you can just click on edit story. You'll be getting the interface here. You can again change the prompts and edit the stuff. So let's see the another video. I think the other video was good. Here you can see first the owner is keeping the food, the dog's food. Next scene, the dog is coming walking and eating the food. So I guess this prompt, this video is kind of good. Only mismatch was the owner's legs, that wasn't quite good, but overall this video is not bad, to be honest. So that's the storyboard feature, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. I got a lot of videos in ChatGPT, Sora, programming and other AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.